seining is using a long net dragged between several people to catch fish and other animals out of the Hudson River estuary. People have been seining here on the Hudson, not just for hundreds of years, but for thousands of years. The type of fish we're going to catch today all depends on the habitat and where on the river we're seining. You're going to find different fish in freshwater, brackish water, or saltwater. Here's some basic equipment you can take with you.
Waders, buckets,
dip nets,
clear containers,
or Ziploc bags,
a battery-powered bubbler,
identification guides,
a seine net.
Even if you can't seine, you can use minnow traps
or eel mops.
To go seining, for educational or scientific purposes, you need to get yourself a permit from the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation. You can find out more at this link here. There are several different ways you can go seining. One way is to stretch the net out perpendicular to the shore, then walk along the beach. When you're ready to pull the net in, the person closest to the beach stands in one place, while the person furthest away curves around in a wide arc till you bring the net up on the beach. If you don't have a lot of beach, you can still stretch the net out. One person stays basically in one place, while the other person goes out deep in a wide circle around to the other side of the beach. Oh, I think I see some fish. Bring that bucket. Oh, look at that.
Grab them.
Absolutely. Get those hands wet. Now let's look under these rocks. Anything in these weeds? Look at that beautiful fish. Oh, yeah. That's a gorgeous one. Here's another one. Yeah. Nice work, everybody. Nice work. We got a couple of fish to look at.
Some sites are easier to seine at low tide. Weights on the bottom keep the net down low.
Boats keep the net on the surface so where we can see it.
Make sure the net's not twisted.
Some nets have a bag in the middle and some don't.
Keep the bottom a little ahead of the top, and once you start fishing, keep moving.
Somebody behind the net can look for snags.
As we get close to shore, keep the net on the bottom.
It's important to get fish in a bucket right away while using wet hands.
Be sure to record the numbers and types of fish you caught.
To figure out what we've caught, we can use an online identification guide or a dichotomous key.
River herring.
Largemouth bass.
Banded killifish.
American eel.
Yay!
Treat all your fish with respect and be sure to return them to the river where they were caught.